Good morning. Another day, another one of these. Well, last week, this video that we put up last Tuesday, 1 week ago exactly, not actually 1 week ago exactly, because we motor paced on Thursday last week. Anyways, last time we put up a video about motor pacing, you guys had lots of questions. I also asked for more topics, and so we're gonna talk about this. It's a Tuesday, which means this is a Tech Talk Tuesday that gets aired on Wednesday. And we're gonna talk about all of this a little bit. We'll run you through a little bit as we go and lots of fun stuff. But let's unload it first. That's it. So two of us, we can unload it. It's real easy. We drop it down by one, get the front down. Not too bad. Oh yeah, and it rained last night, so we got the long sleeve waterproof. Gonna stay warm out there. So I brought the GoPro, I was gonna put it on the back, and I can't do anything right when I try to do something right. Forgot the SD card. I didn't even check, and I should've just, anyways. So I'm gonna throw in some footage from last time we did this, and I'll educate about all of that. So enjoy last week's footage while we go and do this. All right, so the overall premise of motor pacing is to train at an accelerated pace in which you can't really replicate unless you're riding in a group or on a group ride or in a race or behind a scooter. So it has a different effect when you put out the same effort at a faster speed, at a faster cadence. We roll out right here, we're just getting a warm up. We do this for about 20-25 minutes, averaging generally around 25 to 28 miles an hour. And that's a warm up. So once we get in deeper and deeper into it, we'll accelerate that pace. We'll start moving through some motions. But what we're doing is just sitting behind the scooter, getting warmed up, getting the blood flowing, getting a feel for how the wind is gonna be for the day. You'll see here in a little bit when we start moving around and sort of following the wind and following the pocket of the scooter, wind becomes a big thing. But this pace, we're just sitting, chilling, hanging out. We're out by the airport. We do laps around the airport. I can't get away from this place, never. Man, last week I was here like 5 times. Training, actually flying. No more SMF airport, give me a break. Back to business. So our overall time, we're about a quarter of the way into this section, or at this point. So we've been behind the scooter for about 20 minutes, on the gas for about 10 to 15. We've made a turn, and now what was a bit of a tailwind is coming into a crosswind. So where we would previously sit right behind the scooter, we're gonna be sitting off to the rider's left side of the bike. And the wind will constantly shift, and later on into the training session too, when we start doing some small circuits and lots of turns, you'll see that we're constantly chasing behind the scooter and moving from left side to right side and sometimes straight on. So anytime you have a headwind or a tailwind, you're gonna be right behind the scooter. But when you're moving into a cross tailwind, just like you would in a pack, you kind of drop into this echelon type of a scenario. So see here, we're gonna be moving, making a right-hand turn from where we were sitting on the left-hand side of the bike and that crosswind, we're now in a dead headwind. So we'll be coming right onto the back wheel. So sitting right behind the scooter, dead headwind, we're gonna be hunkering down behind the driver as tight as possible. And what you can't see in this image is that there's actually a roller right behind the scooter that's actually mounted to the rear chassis, the frame. It's actually off of an old set of rollers and just gives us a bumper so that if we ride it real closely, it'll spin freely. We don't have to worry about any contact with the actual scooter fender, anything like that. So we're moving in here. This is a pretty unique system that we've started working with, and it's trying to replicate cross racing behind the scooter. So we've found this old abandoned complex, a complex of turns where we've been able to string together lots of U-turns and left-handers and right-handers where we can accelerate behind the scooter, slow it down, speed it up. We kind of work some magic as if we are getting in and out of turns in a cross race, trying to replicate that low speed to high speed accelerations back and forth always on the gas, off the gas, on the gas, off the gas. So after we do a few circuits of that, that ends up accumulating about another 25 to 30 minutes, giving us right about 45 to 50 behind the scooter at this point. So we're gonna be moving into the final section. No turns, we're gonna slowly ramp up our pace. As you can see, well, you can't really see the pace, but right now this, we're moving about 31, 32, 33 miles an hour through all the sections in the turning complex and then on this final stretch. And then depending on the time of year and what we're looking to do and how hard the previous weekend's race was, we'll start to ramp it up. We can see 36, 37, 38 miles an hour towards the very end of this final stretch, kind of into the home run section. You can see it's kind of now a true headwind. We're sitting right behind the driver, trying to stay as close as we can. I'm not a coach, I'm not a scientist. I don't understand all of the magic behind motor pacing and why it works the way it does and why it's so effective. However, everybody knows it's effective. It works really well. That high cadence, high power, high speed training, speed work basically, can have a huge effect, and we found it to be super successful for what we're looking to do during the season, far better than structured interval training or anything like that on your own. Group rides early in the season, motor pacing during the season, that accelerated rate is what we're looking for. So hopefully that gives you a little bit of an idea on what we do behind the scooter. Hope you guys like it. If there's specific parts that I didn't quite cover that you're interested in, let me know below. Hope you enjoyed a Tech Talk Training Tuesday that gets aired on Wednesday. We'll see you guys tomorrow. I don't know what tomorrow holds in store, so we'll find out then. But that's gonna be it. We will see you guys then. Over and out. Peace.